O gracious and most loving God, your presence is here this morning. We turn to you this Advent season and pray that you will bring birth of joy and healing and blessings of hope in us. Let something wonderful begin in us, something surprising and holy. Remind us again that in the midst of our darkness, you will bring peace. Turn our hearts towards you and make us ready to receive your Son, our Lord and Savior. May the words that I bring forth this morning and the meditation of my heart be acceptable unto you. I ask this in your precious name. Amen. 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 Good morning, my brothers and sisters. Here we are gathered for worship on this last Sunday of November, which begins this Advent season. A season when we are reminded of Jesus' coming and his return one day to the earth, when we will actually see him. We don't know, however, when that day will be, so it's important for us to have our lives in order. We don't want our lives to be messy and cluttered. We want to make sure our lives are cleaned up of all the bitterness and greed and selfishness and that which we know we should not be doing. We want to be living our lives that are pleasing to God. That way we can be excited about the fact that Jesus is returning. And you know his life of joy. And we wait for that day. We not only celebrate the coming back of his birth in Bethlehem, but we are also looking forward to his second coming one day. There will be signs. In the reading of Luke 21, 25 through 36, we hear the foretelling of the coming of the Son of Man and how we are exhorted to be prepared, be on guard and alert, praying for strength to stand before the Son of Man, Christ's second advent. The second coming of man. Until Jesus comes, we should be watching and waiting. Many of us know that the word Advent means to come. Something or someone is coming this season. We often think of coming as, you know, coming of the Christmas and the birth of Jesus, but it is also bigger and more important than that. In today's gospel, Jesus speaks of the Son of Man is coming in a cloud. This is to believe to be a metaphor for the future. I quote, Advent is coming of our future and a time when we prepare as best we can. Some look to it with fear and anxiety and worry. People are wondering what's going to happen, Jesus says, and people will faint of fear and foreboding of what's coming to the world. Others look to the future with hope, eagerness, and optimism. The stand up and raise your heads with anticipation and expectancy. What parts of our lives are we fearful of? What parts of our lives are we journey bound? While we plan and prepare for the foreseeable future, the unforeseeable future comes like a thief in the night. It takes us by surprise. How do we prepare for something we cannot see, know, or understand? We might say, God only knows. Think of how Mary felt at Gabriel's announcement that she would give birth to the Son of God. The impossible of a future she never imagined. How could this be? Jesus says, be on guard, be alert, pray. He reminds us that the impossible will happen. That's how we are to live when heaven and earth are passing away. When there is distress among the nations and the powers of heaven are shaken, faith, hope, love, courage, compassion, beauty, forgiveness, healing are the voice of Advent. There are the things that speak to our hearts and tug at our souls. Yes, God is real. They speak the impossible of new life and a transformation of life. We all have a future. Listen to the distress. Listen to the distress of fear as it is presented in this scripture reading this morning. And there will be signs in the sun, in the moon, and in the stars. And on the earth, the stress among the nations, confused by the roaring of the sea waves, people will faint with fear, for the powers of heaven will be shaken. They will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with the power and great glory. While nations react to distress and people are perplexed, Jesus has something important to say to us. Jesus warns followers to be prepared for the second coming. Be on guard. It is coming. This is a speech that envisions what is going to happen when we are present with a time of enormous stress. At a time when the Gentiles' era will end, it will be a time of victory. The time of the coming of man, it will be a time for justice and peace and love. How will you respond, my brothers and sisters? This is addressed to us as disciples. Can we persevere in hard times? Well, many of us have certainly survived the COVID-19 pandemic. For such a time as this, and it is still not over, And although it is all we can do to remain faithful to God, we have to. We have to stay in the Word. We have to pray. We have to have hope. Most of us remember Advent season as little kids, and maybe with our own children, when we'd go to Sunday school and we'd have that Advent calendar, and we have all those little doors, and we open up the doors, and when you look inside each Sunday, it's something wonderful and exciting. It may be a Bible verse or a picture or some type of sweet, but we're excited, we're anticipating, we're waiting for this to come, and we can't wait. And this is the countdown. Each door was open was a sign that Christmas was getting closer. We were counting down those days, as this is a time of expectation, anticipation, and excitement. We look forward to the future. Then something happened. Somewhere along the way, life got really real, and Advent sort of changed its flavor. If we look closely, it might not be a time to count down for Christmas anymore, even though we are rushing around and doing what it is to be prepared. The gospel texts about the destruction of the temple, war, earthquakes, famines, plagues, and betrayal is seen in the earlier verses of chapter 21, verses 1 through 19. It takes on a new meaning here. This was a season of change and looking to a future that was not clear and was not known. We could tell stories about the day our lives were changed. We've lived through seasons of change. We've lived through letting go. Oh, we live to stepping into the uncertain future, maybe a future you don't want. Advent is not as simple and easy as opening little doors on a calendar. The world is not that simple, and life is not that easy. Maybe that's why every year on this day, the first Sunday of Advent, we always hear a gospel that seems to describe the end of the world. There are signs. We will be counting down to the end of the world. Be prepared. This is not just a story about Jesus and his disciples. This is your story and my story. We experience things in our lives. We see it in the world. We see it in our churches. And in our churches, we declare the good news of Christ. There will be signs. Jesus said, more than ever, our world needs to see signs. The longer we live, the more signs we'll see. We'll see and experience things that we might not know and might not understand, but they will be signs. We want to be reminded that those signs are there. Jesus says, if you look, we'll see signs everywhere, in the sun, in the moon, in the stars, in the distress among the nations, and in the roaring of the seas and the waves. Our eyes are riveted on the world, our world of violence and destruction. We see pictures of refugees. It's not hard to spot the signs. These signs, however, are too easily and too quickly misunderstood and misused. Our misunderstanding of the signs pushes us further into darkness and deeper into fear. Our misuse of signs blinds us to the coming of the Son of Man with power and with glory. There will be signs. The signs that Jesus warns us is not threats. Jesus does not ask us to predict the future. He never says that there are signs. He says there will be signs. These are the words of hope and reassurance, but far often they are heard as words of warning and threat. And when they are, the signs are used to predict a future of impending doom and loss. They become indicators that the world will end. And you better shape up. God is coming to get you. That the end of the world has come. Instead, Jesus says, when we see signs, we are to stand up, raise our heads, and know that help is on the way. Our redemption, our healing, our Savior has drawn near. The signs are not a reason to hang our heads in despair or shrink from life. That we can see signs in our lives and in this world means that we're faced with circumstances and events, and God is there with us. That's his promise. The signs are our hope and reassurance that God has not abandoned us, that God notices us, that God cares for us, that God comes and he participates. He participates in our circumstances. Jesus' parable of the fig tree teaches us how to read the signs. The Advent signs are not ordinary, but they can be. But when he tells it in the parable, it's as common as a fig tree sprouting leaves. We see the leaves, and we know something is happening. Summer is already near. It's a new season with new life, new growth, new fruit. This is the promise and good news of Advent. Good news of Advent signs. And yet that promise that the good news is fulfilled is not apart from us, but is with us and through us and with us in our circumstances. And even if it's tragic, it is with us. So my sisters and brothers, what if we looked at our lives and our world and began to read and understand signs of our Advent stories as sprouting leaves? What would you see? Would it mean anything to you? Would it mean that you're entering a new season? Would it mean that you're entering a new life of growth? Would it mean that you would produce good fruit? We could open the little doors of our life with new courage and confidence. We could look on the world with a new sense of compassion and hope. We would be strengthened to do the good work that God has given us to do. God has a certain attitude, you know. God is obliged by his character to warn the world of the imminent return of his Son. God is warning the world today. He is calling the world to repentance. He's talking to the unbelievers. Christians are also being spoken to, and they are called to commit their lives to holiness. Be on alert. The signs of the times are near. This is the Advent season. Yes, God is calling. God is calling us to action. We see signs every day. There's signs of nature, signs of society, spiritual signs, signs of technology, signs of the world politics, signs of Israel. Jewish people and their lands will be regathered. Signs of world politics. When God's wrath is over, we will stand and see Jesus. There are key signs that are important, ones that relate to Israel. God uses the Jews in the scriptures to let us know that the time is coming when the Lord is revealed, and it is an important event for us to remember that they play an important part in our history. God has a call to action. The signs of the time are upon us. They are shouting for our attention. Are you ready? Are you yearning for God's return? Yes, the Advent season of our lives can be long, difficult, and painful, but never face these seasons without the signs of hope, the signs of reassurance, the signs that point you to the one who is coming. There will be signs, said Jesus. Amen, amen, and amen.